Just finished all the shit that I have to do today, and now I can sit down and just chill. I'm gonna be playing some events, I think, with some Jeskai Gideon turns. Hopefully we'll do okay. Just a quick overview. This deck aims to take infinite turns. We can combo out as soon as the opponent's turn three by chance for goring into Gideon on our turn, lining up two turns and then going from there. I tried this. I'm trying it like this for a little bit. Instead of having two Gory Sins and one Alchemist Gambit, I'm trying Gory Sin, Teferi's Protection, Alchemist Gambit. The idea of this deck is basically we want to take infinite turns. This would probably, like, you could probably go up to two and two and drop the Teferi's Protection, or you could go the other way, drop the Gory Sin and go two Teferi's Protection. But I think I'm going to actually drop Teferi's for this set of games because there's a problem with it when we're comboing out. It's actually can be an issue. I think I'm also gonna drop Urza's Ruinous Blast. We're running the marches and we have Graveyard Recursion. That should be able to clear up the board locks. And we'll drop Ruinous Blast for perhaps. Let's do another purge for this set. So that we have answers to wizards. We could also go with another march. But I think it'd be interesting to try it like this. Okay, so the idea of this deck here is using Gideon to break spells that would normally make you lose. We can Gory Sin, Alchemist Gambit, and Chance for Gory all for 3 mana, taking extra turns. We have lots of interactions in the deck, and then we recur it with Lorien Revealed, fetching Mystic Sanctuaries, or, whatever. I think I also needed to address some land balance issues here the last time I played it. So we're short of land, it would appear. That might explain it. So how did I get to a point where I had, it should have 26 lands. So we're just gonna drop one. No wonder I was stalling so hard last time. So it's 21. These count as lands basically. So that's 25. And then we're gonna need one more island based land, ideally something multicolored and or wait. Aha, I know exactly what to Hall of the Storm Giants. Okay, so now we're back up to the proper 26 lands. No wonder I was mana stalling yesterday. When I was tuning the deck, somehow I cut two lands and didn't replace them. So let's this deck is very heavy on the turn three curve. We're completely clear in the turn four except for the ring, and the reason for that is because ideally we want to be casting one of these things into the ring or stalling out the opponent's turn with like a purge into ring and things like that. Okay, I'm pretty satisfied with these changes. I'm thinking though, if I were to take. Yeah, all right, let's run it like this. We'll give this a shot. Maybe we'll do better on lands now that we have the appropriate number in our deck. All right, and before we start games, let me fill this device up. Okay, excellent. Do I have my pokey stick? I do. You never know when you're going to need a Pokestick to clean out things. Come on. Alright, looks good. Now, that. Open this. Oh, man. I got that post-workout noodly body feeling where your arms and legs feel kind of like noodles. Endorphins feeling pretty good, though. Whoop. That goes in there. Alright, let's do this. Let's do this, Leroy Jenkins. Let's see if we can take a million turns. Purge Gideon on the play. We need to hit a land. Looks like we're against Wizards. It's a good hand if we hit a land, but I'm not. Okay, this is better. We'll pitch Glorious End. We'll play our tap land first so that we don't get stuck with it. Hello. Wizards! What a surprise! I've never seen this deck before. Play a creature. Come on. Come on. Play your Arcanist. Of course. Alright, do that and then play Soulscar Mage. Go wider. Come on. Nope, just doing damage. So we're going to purge that then. Or do I play the Oracle? I mean, I could play the Oracle and throw it under the bus and maybe get him to go wider. Or he just burns it and hits me for three. Let's try this line. Alright. Do we even trade in this scenario? Oof. I think I'm just gonna take this. I think I will. If I draw Gideon, I could conceivably chance for Glory creating an indestructible Oracle the Alpha, which would be not impossible for him to deal with since he has Skullscar, but pretty difficult. Alright, I take the hit. What else you got? Symmetry Sage and a Soulscar Mage. Soulscar Mage. Soulscar Mage. Soulscar Mage. Play it, play it, play it. So it can purge all the creatures in your hand. Alright, so we're going to go down to 10. We're also going to attack. Scry. Don't need any more land at this point. Sure. We love that because we don't really like we were not casting Oracle the Alpha for out of exile for at least 3 or 4 turns, so this is just a Wizard Lightning out of his hand for no reason. I mean, that may not actually be true because like it could be that we just don't draw anything. No more hasty shenanigans. All right, well, we have to tank another hit. We do have Surge, which might help with that. We really need a Gideon. Alright, try to burn me. Perfect. But if we get a Gideon, we just go off. Chance for Glory with Island, or with Sanctuary, Steam Vents, and Floodplain, and then play Mystic Sanctuary, put it on top, play Gideon. Alright. So we take 6. Does he have another one? Take 9. Alright. So it would have been lethal, but it's not. All we need is that Gideon. Nope. Alright, well, here's what we do then. Mox Pearl. We're gonna decline this. Decline. Couldn't find the Gideon. There's effectively 7 of them in the deck with the tutors. Are there any 2 mana planeswalker tutors? There's that green spell. The battle that costs 2 mana, I think, and it looks at the top 5 and picks a permanent. Alright. Mind us both drawing cards. All right, we're both gonna draw. Well, it's not the best, but we'll do in a pinch. We almost have an extra turn with Gideon here. This is a sorcery, though. Thinking about it here. Alright, we're just gonna do this.
This is a plane worth saving. It's time to
what do we
give
want
up.
Here? We have Oracle. We have Ring. It does have enough to equip it, so you will be able to kill the Gideon. But we're gonna Ring.
We still have a chance.
Now we can loop rings. Divine Purge is good too. What's this, 3? Yeah. Sure. Portable hole look pretty bad here. So we're almost to the point where we can take like a real extra turn. Next turn we can. So, Metallic Rebuke, how much are we taking? 2. I mean, assuming he doesn't have more Nettles, which he probably does. So, that's 12. Yeah, let's This is, I have to pay it next turn. Thinking. All right. I got it. I don't really got it, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. thinking, all right, I'm just going to pay it. Yeah, I'm going to glaze in this. Creates a servo is actually good. That's less damage than we would have taken, but I think it's still lethal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, we're dead. Alright, we're dead.
Them's the brakes.
Getting smoked. This isn't the strongest deck ever.
I have gotten wins in events with it, though, so it's not like it can't win.
All right, 3 islands, Divine Purge, Andring, March. Cantrip with no value. I don't think that's super great. Let's just get our tap lands out of the way. I'll just take some mana, thank you. Got another one. Alright, but now you're gonna get ring locked. Thank you. think we just loop the ring again, right? Okay. Oh no, that changes things a little bit. But not really. So let's just draw and play the ring again. If he wants to take an extra turn, that's fine. I can purge later. Perfect. Here we go. You want to take an extra turn? You can. When he does that, I'll end the turn. What are you doing, dude? Why? Alright, that's six, so let's Divine Purge. We just take this, right? Because if he taps all the way out, we can take extra turns. Okay. You have one more spell to use? Alright, so let's draw some cards. And go ahead and take another turn. Play Gideon and defend it, and just end the opponent's turn. We're there. These are extra turns, let's basically, so let's just go ahead and do an extra turn. We just pitch the land, because we're going to be getting land from here on out.
They'll have to get through me first. Now it's my turn.
Alright, so we got one. Need more land on the play. Double tap land, but then we got power. Let's try it. We'll go tome. We'll go triumph, triumph. See if we can get there. Did he get a peek at anything? He saw Karn. Cat's out of the bag. Alright, well, I'm gonna shock this in and cast the ring. Oh, that sucks. That sucks a lot. Alright. Divine Purge would be good. At this point, we got a couple turns left, though. Like, it's not over. Shocks it in. What's he play? Alright, well, take me an extra turn. Time to scoop. We're dead. I figured. Alright, we're dead. We don't line up well with, like, tempo shit. We can usually fight out, like, a pure control, but, like, tempo's bad for us. Man, that was a rough session. Do-do-do-do! 50 rupees. Tapped out now, so let's just do some ranked. It has a lot of mana, but it doesn't do anything for a long time. This is not good, but I didn't really want to get a 5. Alright, need land or land cycling, please. Not good. Yes, please. Okay, fuck. Opponent's got land cycling, but I don't. The Lorien domain stuff is good. I like it a lot, actually. You get domain very easily. Make an island spined domain deck. Alright, I can't do anything. Wish I had opponent's hand. Can go. All right, there we go. Yeah. What do we want to do here? I mean, I'm just casting Search for Glory again. Fuck it. Four mana. What do we got in here? Search for Glory. Alright, so let's play. Sure. Okay, good. Get all this out of your hand. You don't like this. Our deck is spicy now. So I think I'm just stalemated for a little bit longer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Actually, I'm not. Get substantially worse because this doesn't hit Quaza, but we can still block, so whatever. Alright, take one. Oh, I bet this guy's running the shit that makes you draw a card for each island. This is actually a really cool deck idea. Okay, that's up to the ring. Draws a card, does damage. I actually like this idea here. Alright, make an extra token. Mox Sapphire. Not what we wanted to see. Alright, we're dead. I like this, it's cool. So he's doing like this card with Island Domain centered around actually that's a really cool idea. I was just thinking about this a little while ago. Actually, I'm gonna brew a little bit. All right, so I was thinking that you could do Orion. You do like control domain. So these two, like, you want ones, this plus this. But only the island ones are fetchable. So you just need an island. Oh. Yeah, so only these are the three triumphs we have access to. So we can get, this one has two overlap, this one has two non-overlap. So we definitely want this. And then we don't need these because they just overlap with existing ones or can't be fetched. So there we go. And then we want to see dual color islands for all, at least one for all five colors. So like, if we wanted white, we could get this. If we wanted black, we can get this. If we want red, green. So that makes at least one of every color fetchable. Four Mystic Sanctuaries. Now we I need to just get these arc. Craftable. That are not lands. Okay, I need four of these. Draw a card. For each. I may have one of those in there, we'll see. This card. Let's look at anything that says it exiles, but it needs to be an artifact. You recycle tribal flames. Linking. This was four, maybe, but I don't think it's good enough. Five. It's definitely not when things like the One Ring exist. Okay, all domain cards, please. I wonder if there would be a way to get Shrapnel Blast together, Tribal Flames. Let me see all my red artifact mentioning cards, please. Kind of cool, actually. Kind of a creative way to destroy the ring. But now we need an artifact presence. Finale would be funny. So many lanes we got? 4, 8, 12. 12 lanes counted for. And we already have too many things in the deck, but I'm going to trim it down in a minute. I have one of these for a while, too. Burning wild cards. See, but I run into problems like this. This doesn't have a really solid plan for the ring. Shrapnel Blast is definitely forced. You wouldn't run it. So that would be out. So that's an easy four cut. Test of Talents is kind of iffy. But alongside Reprieve, it's pretty good. Maelstrom Point, this might be hard to pull off, but if you had it and you fetch, you'll be able to get... you'll be able to plan for it. Bindings and obvious include... Flow of Knowledge is fun because everything's islands. In fact... Leyline, you could conceivably drop the rings and just run Flow of Knowledge and Leyline, but would that mean you could play almost all instant? No, that's not instant, but that is. Six rares left after my spending spree here.